Hello Scorpio, welcome to your monthly reading for August 2019. I hope you're all doing really well. This reading is for Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus sign Scorpio. And if you do have any personal questions, then you will need a personal reading and you can visit my website, katietarot.com. I will also put a link in the description box below. I just want to say welcome if you are new to my channel and thank you so much for liking, subscribing and also sharing, doing all of those wonderful supportive things on my channel. Thank you so much. So let's get into the reading, Scorpio. Let's see what spirit would like to bring through for you, what your guides would like to say and your angels for Scorpio, please, for the month of August. Scorpio. Scorpio. Okay, let's take a look at this first card, Scorpio. Let's see what message is on here. Okay, so we have review and contemplation. Interesting. So it says you've accomplished a great deal in your life and you have much to be proud of. Now it's time to decide what's next. As you contemplate the past and the present, you'll get clear on your divine life purpose. Don't be distracted by conventional thinking. Be the real you. Be the authentic you, Scorpio. You must take that to heart because perhaps you have not been completely authentic in the past or up to this point. Perhaps you have done what other people wanted you to do or what was expected of you. But now is the time in August to really understand, really contemplate, really review what has been going on in your life in general, in a general sense. And for some of you, this is going to be quite specific, okay? So I'm seeing you doing this. I'm seeing that it's going to reignite some passion for you, Scorpio, if you do this. And there'll be healing involved in this process as well. And deciding on what to do next, that's the big question, isn't it? What do you do next? Because there's a sense here of perhaps completion or an ending of sorts. And you're wondering about what the next step is going to be for you. And that's perhaps why some of you need to do this review. You need to really dig deep and assess what's been going on here in the past as well as what's going on now. So then you can get clear about your future path and be on your highest path because that's ultimately what we're all here to do. So I feel this process will reignite some enthusiasm, some passion, some creativity, Scorpio. I feel like it's going to really connect you to your emotions, actually, and perhaps you've been severing that somewhat to keep your sanity or to keep you distant, perhaps because it's been necessary for your survival in some way, for your sanity in some way. So you've been cutting that out. I feel this is like an awakening for someone. This is going to be a moment. It could be a moment in time for someone, a revelation of sorts, where you have a wonderful moment of clarity and then it will become clear what your next step needs to be. So some very interesting, some very transformative energies here for you, Scorpio. Let's take a look at the next card. And we have the Eight of Thought. And it says, you may feel as though you're restricted by the circumstances you find yourself in, but that's just an illusion. Make a promise to yourself to refuse to be stuck in a situation that's making you unhappy. Don't wait for someone to come to the rescue when you can free yourself. If you feel like you are being tied up, like you are bound, you can't see your way through for something in your life. Spirit wants you to know, Scorpio, that you do have the power. You can change this. And sometimes it can be a simple act of changing your thoughts, okay? And that's going to give you the change that you need or the start of something new so you can then perhaps bring something through in the physical, but it starts with your thoughts and the way that you're thinking about this person or about this situation. I am seeing that some of you are closed in. So there is a sense here of perhaps, you know, another a workplace situation, in a relationship, whatever this is for you. There does seem to be a mental kind of grid around you, so you feel like you are enclosed. But know that that is an illusion, and you do have the means, you do have the capability, Scorpio, to step out of this, to step out of the restriction, and to step into a new you, a new energy, a new vibe. I feel, of course, it does tie into this review. You've got to contemplate what's really been going on here. Perhaps get clear, have those conversations. Perhaps you feel tongue-tied. Perhaps you feel like you haven't been able to have a heart-to-heart with someone or to really get your point across. And that's been frustrating for some of you. And maybe that needs to happen, but maybe it actually doesn't. Maybe you need to take some different steps to move forward. And that's what this contemplation is about. And I feel like you will have the clarity by the end of the month to move forward and to not feel restricted in the way that you do at the current moment in whatever area of life this is for you. I feel like there are going to be profound changes for you, Scorpio, and that you will see through the illusion whatever this is for you personally. So very interesting energy coming through there for you. Let's take a look at this final card. And look, we have the Emperor, we have number 4, and it says organization. And it says, your plans are on target and everything will flow more smoothly if you add a little organization and discipline to your methods. The key to success is to allow your creativity to be gently guided by logic. Be open to asking for help from someone very intellectual or seek out a mentor. This is the perfect card for you, I feel, given these two cards beforehand, Scorpio. This is about structure, foundation, about getting a solid footing in the door with someone, with something. It's definitely very much empowered. You are not under the jurisdiction of others here, whether it's an actual physical thing, whether it's in the workplace, or whether it's a mental thing or an emotional thing. You're not tied up by other people's expectations or by the circumstances anymore. You are creating your own rules here, Scorpio. You are making your own life. It doesn't have to necessarily be in alignment with what you have been doing so far. This can be a big change. It can be for some of you, and I feel it is. I am getting a sense here for some of you that you definitely have some divine intervention coming into play here with these angels on this card. I feel like spirit is definitely giving you some messages you may be able to hear or see clairvoyantly or synchronistically in the month of August. What to do, what to say at a certain time, how to go about structuring your life the way that you want it to be, Scorpio, without the restrictions and boundaries that have been tying you up. So definitely empowerment coming into play there, self-empowerment, of course. There is also, for some of you, someone else coming into the picture here. This someone may be related to an organization, so it could be the workplace, it could be an institution of sorts. Someone who is kind of very official, I feel. Someone who has dominion over either lots of people or an organization. And I feel like they are going to, they're going to be a mentor, or they're going to help you in some way. Some positive interaction happening here between you and this person. If this is a relationship, a love relationship for you, I feel like this is more of an empowerment energy. There could be someone coming in, a counselor. It could be some friend or family member who is very much on board with supporting you. That may be the case, but there's also that energy of self-empowerment, you know, getting yourself into your own structure here, your own self. So being very authentic is key, I feel, for you in the month of August, Scorpio. So you've got some very big energies coming through here. We've got two major arcana here with Judgment and with the Emperor. So I feel like there's definitely going to be a shift that happens in August for you in your perception, and that may even follow through in your manifest life. So some great energy is coming through for you. I'm sending you much love and light, and I hope you all have a wonderful month ahead.